Icebreakers. Pool hall. I'm watching Ryan Gulyassy.
Two games.
That's right.
Yeah, this doesn't look good for Mike. Nice shot.
Yeah, this guy's playing good.
Real good. I was watching.
He stays down on the ball. Thank you. back. Back.
He won two, and he's getting two on the wire.
Oh, he's won two already, so yeah. He's already up on the hill.
Yeah. Hold on, I'm going to sit out. I'm going to put it real straight.
Amazing shot, Earl.
Like glimpses of Efren or something.
Man, that was awesome.
The speed on it looked like Efren. The speed on it. They got shape for the floor. That's the only way Efren kicks him. If Efren kicks him, he always plays shape, you know, for the next ball.
That was an amazing shot.
Mike's got a chance here to scratch.
I thought you were done, Earl. I really did. I thought it was over.
That guy was talking at you. I kind of given up a little bit, but...
He was getting in your head.
But I said to myself, after I won the game, I said, when I went up, he had me 4-2. I said, you know, all I got to do is break run out 3 hours. And so I didn't give up. Really. I played pretty hard.
Sure did. That guy was trying to get in your head, too.
Well, that's okay. He might not want to get in there. I just I'm happy I won. I'm happy I made a nice shot for the audience.
Yeah.
I really liked making shots. I don't like hammering them. They're too good for them.
Right.
But the pull one on the moth is nice for the telecast.
That was an amazing shot, and everybody commented on it.
You see a nice a shot that requires some art.
That was awesome.
Some really know-how. You know what I mean?
Yep, you zoned in on it, man. I saw you. You zoned
the
in.
The way I put a lot of spin on the rail, off the rail, the side rail, put a lot of spin on it, you know?
Right.
That's what kicked the ball over towards it off the bottom rail.
Yeah, you got down on the ball.
Mike's running out here. Looks like he's got a relatively easy out into his pocket. Before he spin over to the side rail, it's the left bottom.
And not draw it into the pocket.
That must have scared him a little bit. Now he's all right. He'll either draw back. He'll probably just draw back a little bit. Unless he's got an angle and he's got to go down. He's got to go down tape. But tell it is.
He's playing
two rails and back down the middle of the table.
He's traveling, man.
But like
there.
We're talking about, a lot of times, keeping the ball in the middle of the table is important. You know, usually got a decent shot. But he might have a little longer shot, but he'll have a shot. Keep the ball in the middle of the table. Little left bottom here and just stop this and kind of kill it right there. People at home need to learn how to pinch those balls and don't let the cue ball go away. This is pretty elementary.
Okay, so he has a one now. Another guy's on the hill, Ryan Ward, and Mike Gulyassy has one. But he came in with it two games on the wire.
This guy looks like really kicking it to get it through the middle of the line.
Right.
The way he broke around that first rock.
Mm-hmm.
And he made some pretty tough shots, too.
Yep. You guys are coming up against the good players in the tournament now. You really got to buckle down.
Mike's racking the ball. Scores 1-1.
1-4.
Mike. What's the score?
1-4. So. The other guy's on the hill. Ryan Ward.
He's won two games?
Yeah, because they got two on the wire. Yeah.
He's already won two games.
Oh, he's already won two. He's been playing fast.
It's 4-1. Mike's in a lot of trouble here. I'm so excited about the shot I made, I can't even keep up what's going on here. But Mike breaks the ball pretty well. He's got his orange brush?
Yeah.
Orange brush. Whack the balls.
Well, watching this, it's all about the break in this tournament. And everybody's everybody's hitting them too hard. Mike didn't there. But they're all going up table and clustering up, and everybody's diving that cue ball right into the side pocket.
I used to break the ball so good, not mishit on them, and my timing was off all the time. A lot of people don't realize the timing. It's just like swinging a golf ball to get the things back. Timing is the key. This is the hardest shot in the without a doubt. This is hard to sit in a 95-mile-per-hour baseball. People don't know that. They don't have a clue. Go practice it for 8 hours a day for 40 years and you'll realize how difficult it is. Mike's played a nice safety. He didn't want to be down table. Looks like he's going to have to kick to the side rail to go directly into the one. Just before the side rail. That's a good kick. Because he's going to wound up hitting Mike for a shot. Where it lands is going to knock over the ball.
Right. Looks like he can maybe play a bank, but
I'm sure he'll elect the way. Safe here somehow.
Yes.
Unless there's no safety, then he might get to the bank.
And that's a smart.
The bank looks ill-advised.
Yeah, it's too long of an angle.
But this bar table shows an interesting game. You think you're out of it in this short race, you really ain't. Just win one game, you can win a match. A bottle of water. My break on the last match, I tried this off break. And the first game I broke in good, but I think it was a dead combination. And then, boy, he was in a tough spot. There.
Wow.
So completely out.
Sure did.
This could be a match. All this guy's got to lose, but yeah, I'm sure he's up.
That's what I'm thinking.
I don't never see a score on the line.
I didn't notice you wearing any body armor this time, Earl, or any extensions or weights. You did. Yeah, there's no golf grip. Oh, yeah? Without all the sucky toy, what do they call that?
I just thought I needed it.
The whoopee.
The beekeeper, so was Joe Robinson. I'll tell you what, that Joe Robinson. Oh,
yeah.
This guy is.
Man, he dogged it.
That is amazing. Mike is simply blessed.
Yes, he is. Mike's a blessed man.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
This guy can win the match, too. Right?
Yep.
He's got a chance to stay in the match. Those are just kind of things I can't rely on.
Uh-huh.
I don't want to have to rely on a guy missing the gimme. I'll tell you that. But I do see it happen for a lot of guys, and I think they're very fortunate when it does.
Yes, it's just Mike Scott's his lucky day, man. It's just,
he's a nice guy, but I don't know if he deserves that. No, I like Mike a lot. Tough guy. I played against him for years. I didn't really play for a long time, so I made a few. Always pretty sound, you know what I mean? Doesn't get rough or anything.
Stays down good.
You know?
Stays down good, follows through real good.
He's still got a tough task, though. He's got a tough
This
game is three more, right?
Yes.
So
it's 2-4.
His break's going to have to move up.
Yep.
That's really the key.
I've been watching all these matches, and it's the break.
All he's got to do is have three good breaks.
Mm-hmm. Everybody's hitting them.
But he always got to do is hit one bad break. He's a gentleman.
Just like you did that last match. You got bad on that last break. You took a little too much off of it.
That's scary.
You did.
You kind of just decelerate.
I noticed that.
I was telling you earlier, or someone I was telling, I think it was Mike, about deceleration.
Yep, I heard
it. That's when you miss balls, too. You kind of decelerate. Well, I've done better at this tournament than I did last time I was here. I'm thankful for that. Last time I think I... But I beat myself last time. I should have got out. And got I didn't get the money last time. It's still not easy. It feels like you're giving the guy 200 games. In a race to five, you're giving him two, right? And that's it seems like you're giving the guy 2,000 games or something. Because it's only a race to five.
And these better players now.
And if he wins the game, it feels like you gave him 300 games.
Take the wind out of your sails.
Because it's up 3-0 now. It's weird. It's not totally unfair, believe it or not.
See,
that's how a Mason pool lives. It's that fickle. And it can change the game. And the shot can change the game. Where it's not unfair that I'm giving up this break. It really ain't. If I play well and I break well, I should win.
Yep.
Right?
Absolutely. You're expected to win. I mean, you're a top player.
But I have to do this. I can't afford to make stupid mistakes or
right.
Scratch. And I'm going to rely on a little bit of luck from them, too.
Well, I
watched. Kick in like I got.
Yeah, that was great. But that was skill roll because I watched you get down on the ball. You fouled it out. You saw what you're gonna do.
Right.
You zoned, and as soon as the time was right, as soon as that moment was right, you hit that ball, and it was. Perfect.
I was looking for the spot.
You like zoned in on it. Oh yeah, I can see it.
If I was going like this, what sideways?
And then you got it.
When I got it.
You let it go. You didn't even think twice about it.
So you shoot those shots a whole lot. You sit around and practice.
Oh, and under all the pressure, the guy was on the hill.
It's so weird to make a shot. It's 2 feet out of the hole.
It was unbelievable.
Yeah, like I was hanging in the hole.
It was absolutely unbelievable.
Yeah, the pop him. He was the pop.
Oh, yeah.
Got
shaped. Oh, yeah.
The filling in your body's like, you just got arrested for a pound of coke. You know what I mean? You're going to jail for 1,000 years. That's the feeling you got when the guy gets a shot on you like that. Because that's what I felt like when Reyes kicked that ball in on me in Reno that time. That was unreal. I wanted to throw up. You know? But
it's cool.
Great moments are supposed to happen eventually. Good, I get somebody else one time, but I wish it would have been on Africa. The bartender.
Yeah.
What are you going to do? You got to keep running out. Mm-hmm. All right, Mike's going to win this game.
Okay.
Straight into the line. This is Mississippi. Right now, he needs two more games, right?
Yes, sir.
So he scores 4-3.
That's right. I heard you had a new DVD coming out, or it's out now.
Yeah, we made a new DVD. It's short and sweet. It's 26 minutes. It's got some trick shots on it, some straight shots. It's got some segments of me doing exhibitions and talking to people throughout the exhibition. And being asked some questions throughout the video where I'm explaining my views on things. It's interesting. It's, you know, it's got a variety of things. 26 minutes, short and sweet. Have a beer.
You can find that
sit down, have a coke.
At his website, Babies Pro.
Watch it for 26 minutes. Show it to your friends once in a while. I'm not the smartest man in the world. I know what I'm doing. I know what I want to do. I know what we should do for people.
Well, you're more people's favorite player.
It's my sport, and I got to write titles I'm entitled to say what I feel about it.
Absolutely. I've never.
A baseball player's playing baseball. He's got a right to say what he feels about baseball.
You're everybody's favorite player, man. The more people I've met, they all like you more than any of the other players.
It's
that and Efren. You know, you and Efren are at the top.
That guy played a great shot. Right
he
there.
Sure
I'm
did.
I'm going to tell you what, that was some trouble. Now, Finney hit that ball. He could have kicked it and actually sold out. But he hit it so thin that he actually almost kicked it and it sold out. That was a great shot. I don't know that I could think of that shot on the way hit. And if he hits a little funny, it goes all the way over the corner. He had to hit that super thin shot. Those shots are terrifying. You're scared you're going to miss the whole ball. Mike can see the edge of this thing.
Yeah, he can see it.
He can shoot the edge of the ball. Mike thought he had to kick up.
Okay. He's going to hide behind that four ball.
Great shot.
That was a good shot. That was a great shot.
This guy's not going to jump. That's good.
Yeah, but you've been jumping lately.
I'm going to start using the post.
You don't care anymore.
Wow.
And then he locked him up.
How good did he hit that?
He hit it real nice.
The reason why that happened is he hit the one ball nice and solid when he kicked it. And that's what enabled the ball to follow down the table. It's amazing. When you kick the ball solid, good things happen. It really does. When you kick them the right speed and solid, good things happen. Reyes is a perfect example. He doesn't hear anybody ever see.
Mm-hmm.
The speed of the shot, like that. The ball I kicked on goes on a lot like the
yeah, it
he
was.
He would have got position. I was surprised I got position.
Yeah, you did.
But now Mike's got a tough kick. He's got a kick bottom rail, side rail. This is really good. Really small ball.
Well, I've seen you come back for some major. Like, I was
in.
Did
he hit the one ball?
Yes, he did.
That was unbelievable. That was a nice shot. That was a nice shot. Wow. He had to spin that too. You know that? He had to put a little bit of spin on it, which then you can't judge it a lot of times. You put a little spin, more spin on it.
Hmm.
You can't judge it. But he did leave him a straight in shot, which was unfortunate. And now he's on the wrong side of the ball. I can't tell.
I can't tell.
I'm blind almost now.
He's jumping up over it or he's massaying it or something. He just stepped up and swung at that thing.
He got away with it. Mike might have a combination for the corner on the five, but I can't.
That's a lot of.
I know he can see the edge of the two. If he can see the whole two ball, he might play the five, but maybe.
I don't know if he can even see it.
He's going to have to elect to play some kind of safety.
Eventually, I'll have more cameras I can see more angles. He looks like he's going at the combo, so he obviously can see the ball.
I didn't play like that years ago. I kind of do that now myself. Really. Slow strokes. He's over hit that shot. Now he's going to have to play safe. Ford's behind the six.
I can't believe he did that. He totally had the match.
Yeah, he's kind of like nervous all the time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know, kind of not playing up to his expectations. Mm-hmm. That's cool. It's a funny game.
It is.
Nervous, you can't do nothing.
The tiniest thing in your head.
It's an amazing game.
It is an amazing game.
He's missed this ball, but it's a good miss. He didn't play the game.
No.
He played that shot. Now Mike's got to kick the three from the side rail.
He wants ball in hand. This guy wants ball in hand.
He could luck the nine ball. He's looking at it. But it's hard to hit that side of the ball, you know, from that kick.
Sure.
Because you're taking a real risk of not hitting the ball. And when you got a kick like this, it's so hard to hit that side of the ball. He's pointing at the back of the ball here. I still think he'll hit this ball pretty full. He hits the back of the ball as a good shot. I expect.
No, it's going sailing. Well.
He used to put some bottom on that. I wouldn't have put bottom on that. That's what sent it in the corner. If he puts top on it, you know, and doesn't draw it, it couldn't do that. You know what I mean? He must, I didn't see how he approached it. He must have elevated.
He was.
Put some bottom on it. That's the only way he could have scratched back here. Well, he should be out. This guy, the way this guy's playing right now, I can't guarantee he can get out.
Yeah, I mean, these guys will. I mean, this.
I mean, he's quite good. Oh, man. Right?
Yeah, I mean, he's making mistakes. I don't know what it is. It's like you said, it's a crazy game, man. You can go from masterful play to amateur.
Just a little something sets in your body, you know,
yeah.
Like it just for a while, it sends you in the wrong direction. It's full nervousness is all it is. I guess Mayhem got nervous on that chip the other day, what a chunk.
I was in the Philippines when you were there and watched you come back from 5-0 and win 9 straight games.
I was playing that kid.
Yeah. Yes.
He had me 5-0.
5-0. Yep. I was in your corner there.
Well, there it is. Mike.
Okay.
I guess Mike didn't play a little well.
He was
last
Mike came right out of the gate behind 2 games, so you know he's fighting.
I'll tell you
just
what,
like you.
The guy 2 games, he wins
the first one.
I think he wins the first one. There's so much pressure.
Yeah.
You're down 3-0. You got to win 5 games. He's playing. That's a scary spot to be in. Like I said, this race is short. If you're a good enough player, like myself. If I'm down 4-1, I can still win. But I think if the guy's got 3 and I got none, I got to have a game.
We're going to see what you can do here, Earl. You're still on the winner's side, so let's see how you do.
Yeah, I've been pretty fortunate so far. I've had 3 hill matches. It's pretty common that I'm going to have a hill match. Like I said, I'm the type of player that I should go.
Yes.
I don't expect Mike to. He's not good. Mike's a good player, and he finished second. Which I was surprised to finish second. You know, he's got a win.
The pressure is you're expected to win, Earl. You're expected to win. That's got to add pressure, too. It is.
He's got a scratch. He's got to make a ball. He's got to keep making a ball. That's the key to You know, when I won the U.S. Open Bowl, you know, last December. That was the key to victory there. Got it. It's almost imperative to make the plan A. But you got no chance.
Sure. Were you doing this second ball break? Or this?
No, I was breaking, putting the ball dead
in the center.
Bridging off the bottom barrel, the bridge, and just warped.
Corey plays that ball
straight back. You know why I figured it out? Shane does it. He does all the big time to shake that ball. He does something out there, but he cranks them a few buckets straight down the day.
Wow.
And they can't nothing disturb him. This guy, you know?
Nice.
I says, God, if I can figure out how to do that, I might win this tournament. Well, I'm glad he didn't get to the finals, though. I know he's going to roast me. He tried to walk three of them, didn't he? I thank God Appleton beat him, and then I beat Appleton.
Nobody's going to roast
you. It worked out perfect for me. But Shane wanted me. You know, Shane and I had never played the tournament.
No?
Not yet. It's amazing. But, of course, I'm not playing. I'm not as active as I was, right? Because, you know, there's depression right now. It ain't worth it to go out and play like that. I'm kind of preserving myself. Don't worry, I'll get through this full depression. And when things pick up again, I'll be right there.
Okay.
Same back channel, same full channel. Right back. And you'll go, where did this guy come from? I thought he was deceased. A lot of people think I'm dead, you know. I'm far from dead, I'll tell you that. Unless something kills me in the next few days.
All right, well, thanks for joining us.
You got another match? Huh?
No, these guys are just banging balls.
But anyway, I'm sad Mike Ross, he's my buddy, and I work together. You know, I represent his kid. That's the way it goes.
The way it goes in pool.
That's the nature of the game, man.
It's anybody's game.
All right, I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Thanks, Earl.
Everybody. Thanks for listening.
All right.
And this is Earl Shrimp signing off.
This is Alvin signing off. Bye.